Okay. Hey there, fans. This is your synth crazed professor of noise. So I'm going to be showing a little bit about the Syntrx Mark II. And so I have this patch lined up now. I'm not going to put graphics on this video, so you can see the patch itself. So there's no patch on that spot, and what you're going to hear is this patch. So if you just observe, freeze the screen or whatever, look at all the knobs, all the switches, how they're set, everything, the level of a little random, level of this, level of that, everything. Joystick right in the middle, and I believe there's no sequence on this yet, so I'm going to run it without the sequence, and then we're going to add a little sequence on. And so here it goes. We're just going to kind of let it jam out. By the way, all sounds are internal, including effects. Thank you. tasty taste of the oh-so-delicious Syntrx Mark II. So yeah, all you nerds out there, you just gotta do exactly what I did as far as the setup goes. These don't matter. The sync is never on, it's always off. Put the oscillators up in the middle. Set the left one to like say one, the octave. Put the octave on this one at say zero. Leave these all kind of low. In fact, all my patches, I start them off almost in the same position every time, because you can always put it back to very similar. It's easy to find this similar setup every time, you know. So that's a tip after being on this for a little bit, night and day, here and there. And also another thing is you want to pan your outputs and just never touch them. I mean, sure, you could do some wild mixy, acidy, whatever, effecty, kooky. Sure, do it, but because you can't animate those over here. So, but I prefer to just have it this way. That's just me. And I like to, if I want to do wacky stuff, I'll do it in the computer. So I'm about to make another video that is the most basic setup. You'll see that one too.